These are no ordinary snakes. Namibs. Baba would say that Namibs were the creation of a great world-devouring beast.
Your Baba had the Griot's gift.
For better and for worse. Swamp waters sought to drown the homes of living souls. gripping coil of the snake never failed to worry the boy.
We are missing something. Let us return to this when we are better prepared. Another obstruction to hinder the afflicted. Humans do enjoy locking off their land.
Strange. Half of the bridge is broken. We will get to Kivuli once we lower this bridge. Let us begin. That should lower the bridge.
Come then, to Kivuli.
Did you hear that? That is a Kivulian distress signal.
You are certain?
Most certain. We should follow the sound.
I did not hear a horn. Regardless, it is dangerous to seek the sound of strangers.
We found Liana, and that worked out well for us. If anyone is still here, we should do our best to help them.
Defenses are still active. Did not the ancestral war end many moons ago?
It did.
Then their activation was no accident. Be on your guard, Shaman. Path to Ichoko is blocked. Let us focus our attention on Kivuli for now.
These woods, I remember them so vividly. Baba and I would play hide and seek, I would dodge and weave through the trees, always watching his movements. He would beat his arms like an owl, making these silly hooting sounds as he came looking for me. And he always caught me. Always.
What am I doing? Now's not the time for memories. Focus.
The same distress horn. We must be getting closer. Past the gate.
Zhao, I do not hear this horn. Are you sure?
Past this gate. We need to open this gate. First key.
Boy lost himself in the moment as he weaved down the floor.
the second key.
The stench of decay strengthens the deeper we go.
It even permeates my form. The spirits here must be suffering deeply.
What happened here? horn again.
Yes, I heard it this time.
It's so quiet. Strange to be able to hear my thoughts clearly, you know?
Silence can often pierce even the thickest fog of the mind.
I do not often like silence. When Baba first became ill, our home was anything but silent. People from all over Amandla came to visit. So many people. Every hour of the day, laughing and crying and praying. I knew Baba was getting tired, but he just never said anything, never told them politely to go. In those moments, all I wanted was for them to leave. I feel terrible saying it, but I just wanted to be with my Baba, alone. Then they left, and they never came back. What a fool I was, chasing that silence, then praying for the silence to leave.